Nuyans have never found fear in the thought of death. How could they? Their patron deity is the goddess of the hereafter. Death means reuniting with her, she who, as a living goddess, gave her life to save all people. With the last wisps of energy in her divine soul, she sent all races to a new land. Everyone lost their old kingdoms, their old gods, and their old heroes. But none felt this loss as keenly as the followers of Nui. Some would have even preferred to follow her to the hereafter. I was one of them. On their new continent, the Nuians found nothing but ancient, untamed wilds. They dreamt of their magnificent civilization back on Auroria. But their reality had shrunk to leaky lean-tos and rocky fields that would not yield. The elemental specters that had ruled the area for eons tormented Nui's chosen endlessly. They reigned from an ancient labyrinth hidden in the forest. The powerful Archmage Solzrian led an assault on the maze, wresting control from the spirits. The elemental specters retreated. They knew that the owner is always he who holds the key. Solzrian built a grand castle over the labyrinth, declaring whoever conquered it would be king. Following this rule, the Nuians reclaimed some former glory and learned to love their new land. However, roads remained smooth only for so long. A young upstart shunned the labyrinth and rallied an army to conquer the lands he desired. Even the two greatest Nuian cities fell. He consolidated power, dubbing his kingdom Two Crowns, and forged a new kind of peace. Until tragedy struck again, a royal assassination. The Nuians struggled to carry on. None realized that a dark secret had infected the kingdom, and that was the problem. The Nuians wasted time battling each other when their real enemy was this tumorous darkness. The Nuians cried out to their goddess for answers, but received nothing in return. The statues they'd carved simply gazed down at them with a cold, stone benevolence. No other race could ever understand that pain. My pain, the longing for Nui. But no matter what, they are still children of the goddess. Some are even marked with her love. As for me, I will keep my promise to protect them. They just need to remember. The war that began centuries ago is not over yet.
Okay, this is the loading screen. You just watched the movie and for the introduction, this is the loading screen. And okay, now it's time to begin. Okay, so now we're starting in the middle of the middle of water. Oh, small lake. Okay, on the right you can see a map on transparency, and okay, this is the beginning, and we just landed from the water. Okay, this is the quest. You see the exclamation mark? It looks like other famous RPGs, and it means that this NPC has a quest for us. So, just accepted this quest, and we are going through the game to complete the first quest here. And you can see the yellow hammer there is another quest, and Yellowhammer is quest to kill foxes. Anyway, usually it asks you to kill monsters, and it's a quest that is automatically completed once you kill the third monsters. They ask. So now we have to kill 3 foxes, for example, and we can find many of them. Okay, this is the character information. You can see the stats. You can see the equipment and. Okay, we are level 1 because we have just begun, and okay, now first we use the bow, now we are using sword and shield, as you can see, small round shield. Okay, the first fox has been beaten, and you collect the loot once they are killed. The items of the second fox. Okay, now we are level 2. So, greeting, congratulations, guys. We are level 2. Now we're doing okay. Okay. Third fox was killed. Okay, now on the bottom you can see the percentage and the bar. This experience bar is a percentage of the level. So now we are level 2, 20.20%. Means that we need 80%, about 80% to complete the level and to go to level 3. Okay, another quest. Okay, here we just saw a green exclamation mark. Green exclamation mark means that the quests are race related, so they are exclusive to the race now. Here. These quests are exclusive to Nuyens, so the human race of the Western continent, whilst the yellow exclamation marks are the regional quests. So quests are available in this region, beside the race of the player. Okay, this one asks to kill 3 boars and to collect the meat. Okay, now we just finished. Okay, this green. Quest means it's a quest first related. So now we have the prophet telling us about the prophecy. Now another one. Okay. Yeah, there is. See, he told us about this strange birthmark, and now this chain quest, because we finish one and we start another one. And okay, there are also other players playing. Okay, now you know that you can interact a lot with the environment. So this is the meaning of it. Yeah, you throw a dagger, for example, to the target.
Target is too close.
Okay, but anyway, you can interact with the environment, and this is very nice, because, for example, now we're drawing water, because this game, as we said, is like a sandbox. It means that you can interact a lot with the environment. For example, now, he just lit up the street light, and you can see it, for example, you can interact with a lot of stuff here. And okay, now the one quest is to collect the boar meat, so to kill 3 boars. Of course, these monsters are monsters of that you can find at the beginning, so they're quite considered, they're weak, of course, but now we earn 1 skill point, so you can spend the skill point. So, for example, these skills are the skills for Battle Rage skill set. So what are you choosing, Johnny?
Charge.
Charge is. Strong hit on the monster. Okay, it's done. Actually, he pulled down the balls. Okay, now he collected 2 or 3, and we need another one. Okay, just collected. Okay, quest is finished. And you can see there are other players playing, so because this game is played by a lot of players. I mean, it's not desert at all. You can see a lot of new players playing right now, this exact moment. Okay, now we're starting new quests. Okay. Now we have to report to people. So, what are your first impressions, Johnny, about this game?
Yeah, I think it's gonna be a good game because I like the sandbox aspect. I think it's gonna be fun.
Yes, and okay, now we are. Yeah, at the beginning, of course, there are a lot of quests, and they're quite easy. They are quite quick. Yeah, because it's somewhat of a tutorial to get confidence in the game. And of course, at the beginning, then things becomes harder and more interesting, of course. Okay, so now we have to report. Okay, now we have to. Okay, two quests are to report to people, and then we have to. Yeah, to plant the young sapling, because in this game you can plant herbs on the ground. For example, this is the level 4, and of course at the beginning it's leveling is very quick, and of course in this game you can also plant herbs for farming, and this was just a way to understand how to do it. I mean, these quests are some kind of tutorial quests. Okay, now we see. Yeah, there are empty bottles. Oh, empty bottle. Oh, we have. Okay, now. This bath is tipsy, so we feel stronger but we're intoxicated. It's like alcohol, so I mean, I feel better, even if it's not that. Okay, we have to take medicine to the old lady, Rona. I think that we have to be quick because this old lady is not looking good. I mean, she's not old. Yeah, it's not as old, but she doesn't look fine. I mean, she needs. I'm a bit worried about Rona. She doesn't. I mean, she doesn't look good. What do you think, Johnny?
I think she's okay now since I took the medicine to her. So whatever.
Okay, but I mean, she's that good.
Let's try this glass.
Oh, we need to find. The missing girl. Let's go look for her. And okay, so, of course, on the right you can see on transparency, you can see the map. It's very nice because it's not so invasive. I mean, you can still see your current for example landscape without troubles. You can play normally, you can play instruments, and in the meanwhile you can see where to go because roads are highlighted in white, but the rest of the map is transparent. So okay, now let's dance. What else? Of course, on the right you can also see the reminder of the quests when you can check what do you need, for example, to finish a quest here. Of course you can hide it, but anyway you can see, for example, what do you need to finish a quest, complete it, and so it's very good to remind it, because when you have a lot of quests it's very difficult to memorize all of them and to understand where at what point of the quest you are. Okay, now we need to kill three brown bears, either hungry or angry. So we just need one hungry. Okay.
So
So, Johnny, how is the game mechanics? I mean, the battle system.
Yeah, it's pretty like every other mod I tried. I know there is a combo system, and you will get a glow here, and you'll know that you can combo with another skill.
Yeah, okay, of course, combos are meant to deal more damage. Yeah. A bigger damage at the same time, yeah. So if you manage to perform the right combo, you will deal a lot of damage at once, and it's not important, for example, for this initial for this monster, because we are at the beginning, they are quite weak, but for strong monsters and bosses, for example, they are fundamental, because you can deal a lot of damage. In that case, it would change the outcome of the combat. Now we have just found the little girl, Jenny, and of course all the other children threw the doll on the tree, and it's quite it's not good. So we see another player here, another game, another friend, another gamer, friend of us. No, do you know who is Kaker?
What?
The other player.
And?
Do you know him?
No, of course not.
Yeah, but I hope he will watch our, of course not our live stream on Twitch, because he's playing, but maybe YouTube video. Okay, here's the doll. Okay, we lost the doll because the other player took the doll. So there is no doll anymore. Okay, off. You see, if you fall, you have fall damage, because you fall from the height. And of course, there is that trait of Ferian that prevent them 20% of damage while falling from heights. Oh, wait, we see another doll. Okay, of course. Okay, other damages, yes, because it's funny like that, just to make it a bit quicker. So, okay, this is the. Oh, okay, now we have to find the father. This is Captain Killick and the friend of Captain Killick, and we need to look for them. And okay, they're right here. So we have Scout Philip and Captain Killick. So.